The first example of practice set 5.2. And this practice set 5.2, all the examples are depending on the test for parallelogram which you have studied before this. So let's see what is given in the example and what is asked to find out. Here you can see the figure. The name of the figure is given, that's a quadrilateral ABCD. It is given that this quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. So in the given thing we'll write here, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. One more given thing is there like this, that P is midpoint of AB and Q is midpoint of DC. So that also you can add here in the given thing. Now, what is asked to prove here? If you join AQ and PC, then you will get one more quadrilateral. That quadrilateral, it is, name of that quadrilateral is APCQ. So this quadrilateral APCQ is also a parallelogram. That we have to prove. So for this purpose, we are going to take help of test for parallelogram. Now as it is, here the information is given about the sides. So we have to use here the test for parallelogram, that is regarding sides only, that is opposite side test. So let's see which test will be suitable for using to prove here APCQ is a parallelogram. Now, we'll start first of all with a given thing. What is the given thing here? That quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. First thing. Second thing, P is midpoint of AB. So here two equal parts are formed, AP and PB. They are equal to each other. Q is the midpoint of DC. So DQ and QC, they are equal to each other. And here we can say that opposite sides of the parallelogram are congruent. So AB is congruent to DC. So here, as the information about one pair of opposite side of quadrilateral ABCD is given, we'll make use of that. So first of all, we'll say that opposite sides of the parallelogram are congruent, and therefore side AB is congruent to side DC. This is the property of parallelogram which we have to write. Okay. And by the definition, what is parallelogram? Parallelogram is nothing but the pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other. Now here one only pair of opposite side we'll consider, that is AB and DC. So you can start with the congruent side or you can start with the parallel side also. Let's start here. As I have written here, I have started with the parallel side. So, a pair of opposite side is parallel. Which pair of opposite sides? Side AB and side DC is parallel to each other. So, here we'll write here, that is side AB parallel to side DC. Reason we'll write, always we have to write the reason. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent. Sorry. Here we should write opposite sides of the parallelogram are. Only this much is enough. Opposite sides of parallelogram. Correct. So, now here, what is our aim? Quadrilateral APCQ, we have to prove that it is a parallelogram. So, one pair of opposite side of this quadrilateral, that is AP and QC. AP and QC, that we have to show that it is also parallel. So, from the given thing, of parallelogram ABCD, as we have written here that AB is parallel to DC, so we can prove that AP is also parallel to QC. Side AP is parallel to side QC. What is the reason for this? That A dash P dash B means these are collinear points. Point P is between point A and B. Similarly, D dash Q dash C. What is the meaning of this? Point D, Q and C are collinear, as well as point Q is between D and C. Q is the midpoint of DC here. So we can make use of this and we can say that If AB is parallel to DC, so AP is also parallel to QC. AP is parallel to QC. So we'll write here side AP parallel to side CQ or QC. And we'll number here, that is, it is the first, suppose our reason first. Second, we'll make use of the another property of the parallelogram, that is, opposite sides are congruent. So here side AB is parallel to side DC. Side AB is parallel to DC. AB is parallel to DC as well as AB is congruent to DC. What is the reason? Opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent. So here AB is congruent to DC. Are you understanding which test for the parallelogram we are going to use here? We are going to use here the last test, fourth test which I have learned, that is the test for parallelogram. In a quadrilateral, if a pair, that is the single pair or the same single pair of opposite side is parallel as well as congruent, then that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Correct? So here in this quadrilateral, we have proved AP is congruent to AP is parallel to QC. We have to prove here that AP is also congruent to QC. Then we can say that this APCQ is a parallelogram. So one thing we'll prove here, that is, side AP is parallel to side CQ. Now we'll prove AP is congruent to QC. For that purpose, we'll make use of AB is congruent to DC. If we make half of AB, that will be equal to half of DC. Now half of AB, we can write AB. We can write AB because P is midpoint of AB. And half of DC, we can write QC because this Q is midpoint of DC. Therefore, we can say that half of AB means AP and half of DC means QC, they are congruent to each other. So we can write here AP is congruent equal to QC means AP is congruent to QC. So this is our second reason we have got here to prove that this quadrilateral APCQ is a parallelogram. So from 1 and 2, what is given in 1? Opposite pair of sides of this quadrilateral AP and QC is parallel. In the second, we have proved that it is congruent. Both the sides are congruent or equal. So from this, we can prove that this quadrilateral is a parallelogram. And you can write here the reason, that is, by the test of parallelogram. Which test of the parallelogram? If you want to write, you can write the whole statement of that test, or you can simply give the reason by the test of parallelogram. Okay, so this is the proof of this first example which is asked here. This is the second example of this practice set 5.2. Let's see what is asked in the example and given. Using opposite angle test for parallelogram, prove that every rectangle is a parallelogram. So what we have to prove here? That every rectangle is a parallelogram. So we need to draw here diagram. That is, the given thing is there, that the quadrilateral which is given, that is rectangle. So let's draw the figure of rectangle ABCD. Let's name it. So what is given? Quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle. And what we have to prove? We have to prove here that the quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. First of all, whenever we say rectangle, the one property of rectangle, the main property of the rectangle is there, that is regarding the angles. What is that? Each angle of a rectangle is a right angle of 90 degree. So let's mark here angle A 90 degree, B is 90 degree, C is 90 degree and angle D is also of 90 degree. So we'll start with the given thing. Quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle. So angle A is equal to angle B, which is equal to angle C and angle D, and each of them have the measure 90 degree. because they are the angles of a rectangle. Now here we can make a pair of opposite angles, because we have to prove this by opposite angle test for parallelogram. So let's take the pair of opposite angle. Which is the pair of opposite angles? Angle A and C, angle D and angle B. So here we'll write, from this we can write, angle A and angle C, that is angle A and angle C opposite angles, and angle B and angle D, they are also opposite angles, pair of second pair of opposite angles, they both are congruent. One and the same thing we have written here. Only we have made here pair of opposite angles, because we have to use here opposite angle test for parallelogram. So from one we have written here the pair of opposite angles are congruent, and therefore we can say that quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram by the test for parallelogram. Let's see the statement. In a quadrilateral, if pair of opposite angles are congruent, then that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Okay, so therefore it's a very simply we will get here proof, that is every rectangle is a parallelogram. Like this way you can make use of test for parallelogram, which I have learnt before. Now this is the fourth example of this practice set. Here it is given that quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram and angle A is bisected by ray AR, angle D is bisected by ray DP, angle C is bisected by ray CP or CQ, and angle B is also bisected by ray BR. Because of this bisectors, at their point of intersection, if we join these four vertices, then we get a quadrilateral PQRS. So here it is asked to prove that this quadrilateral is a rectangle. And so how to prove this? For this purpose, we'll start with the given thing, that is the quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Now the property of the adjacent angles of the parallelogram we'll use here, that is angle A and angle D. This one pair of adjacent angles we'll select. The adjacent angles of the parallelogram are supplementary, so we'll say that their sum is 180. So angle A plus angle D is equal to 180 degree, that we'll write. Now we'll do half of angle A and half of angle D, so that will be, their sum will be equal to half of 180 degree. Why we are doing half? So that we can get half of angle A, that is this angle, angle SAD. Half of angle D, that is angle SDA. These two angles will get, and their sum is 90 degree. Okay? Because angle A is bisected by AR and angle D is bisected by ray DP. So here, this will use in the triangle, that is ASD. In this triangle, we'll use the measures of these two. What is that? In this triangle ASD, by the property of the triangle, angle SAD plus angle SDA plus angle ASD, sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So we'll write here, the sum of the three angles is 180 degree by property of the triangle. Now here, the sum of two angles we are knowing 90 degree, that will fill here the value, the measure, and we'll find out angle ASD is equal to 90 degree. So here this angle ASD is equal to 90 degree. Once we have proved this angle ASD is equal to 90 degree, we can say that its vertically opposite angle PSR, angle PSR, this angle is also 90 degree. So we can write angle PSR is equal to 90 degree. So in this quadrilateral PQRS, one of the angle we have proved that it is of 90 degree right angle. Similarly, by the same method of taking the pair of adjacent angle which are supplementary and making half of them, and by using property of the triangle in that particular triangle, we can prove here that all the three angles, remaining three angles of the quadrilateral PQRS, that is angle SPQ, angle PQR and angle SRQ, these all are 90 degree. Each measure is 90 degree, that is they all are right angle. So once we prove that these all four angles are, each angle is of 90 degree, all four angles are right angle, then we can say that this quadrilateral PQRS is a rectangle by definition. So like this way we can make use of quadrilateral, that is parallelogram. We can make use of test for parallelogram, and we can say that whatever the property is used, it will be beneficial for proving whatever is asked. That here how it is asked that if ABCD is a parallelogram, then prove that PQRS is a rectangle. So we can make use of test for parallelogram. We can make use of properties of the parallelogram here. Okay. In the next video, we'll see the properties of rectangle, rhombus, and square, and depending on that examples. So here today we have seen the four examples we have solved here. In those four examples, we have revised what is the test of parallelogram, as well as the test along with the test of parallelogram, how can we make use of properties of the parallelogram to solve the examples. Thank you.